are here with Ashlyn in River Medical today, chatting about breast augmentation and some of the most common questions around that. So Ashlyn, like, do you have kind of a typical woman who comes in looking for breast augmentation? Is there a common age or?
No, there isn't a common age. What's really interesting is obviously we don't treat anyone under the age of 18, but it's all ages of life. You know, a lot of women in their 30s, 40s, actually we've ladies who've had breast augmentation when they were younger and they're back in their 50s and 60s for replacements as well. So it covers all ages.
Okay, so it's not really something that's just for younger girls at all, really?
No, absolutely not. And what's really interesting is a lot of women post-babies, that's when they're going to have the breast augmentation. So a lot of people put it in, like you said, oh, it's a young person, it's 20-something. No, it's for everybody.
Okay. And is there a common size, like, is there a typical size people tend to go for, or does it vary a lot?
No, I think what we hear every day here in the clinic is people want a natural look. They don't want the fake large breasts that look like they've had a breast augmentation. They just want to improve their figure, look natural. And that's what we're known for here at River Medical, is the natural look.
Okay. And but let's say if I did want to go like quite big and I come in, can I get any size that I want? Or would a surgeon say to me, no, you know what, double D is going to be too big, you can't have that?
Well, you're a very small person, and yes, our consultant would say a double D would be too big. Our consultant has a really unique approach. He works with the shape of your body, the width of your shoulders, the width of your rib cage, and he doesn't pre-order an implant. So he doesn't go, this is the size. He'll give you a range and you'll try on sizers. You'll decide and say, well, I like that size. But then when he goes and brings you into theatre and you're asleep, he has a bank of implants to choose from. And he uses an empty sizer, which looks like an empty implant. He creates the pocket for the implant, and then he fills that, and he both breasts, and he'll look at the size, and he'll increase it and decrease it. And then when he's happy that that's the best size for your body, he'll deflate them and pick the implant and put them in that way. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So basically what he's doing is, he's listening to what you want, he'll tell you if it can be achievable or not, and then he'll customize it. It's not one size fits all, or let's just do this. He wants to make it for your body, not like an assembly line.
Then what about, there's all different kinds of implants, so like there's saline, there's silicone, there's round, there's teardrop. How do you know what type of implant to get, like, and what's the difference between them?
Okay, well, there is so many implants on the market. We use an FDA approved implant known as Mentor. It's one of the safest ones. So for us, it's all about safety. The implants that we generally use will be silicone, and it's a cohesive gel. So if they ever ruptured and the implant, which is very rare, the implant just stays in like a jelly form in the pocket of in the breast. The question about round versus teardrop is quite controversial, and generally the surgeon will recommend round. Teardrop, a lot of people have lost volume here on the top,
okay.
So most of the implant that is sitting here, so they can look a little bit droopy. So it's volumization here, but it's all down to the particular patient, and your consultant will go through that with you and what's the best for your body and will look the best and the most natural for you.
Okay. And then in terms of after you've had the surgery, then what kind of recovery is involved?
It's a really good question. From a recovery point of view, I always explain to patients, you have the smallest incision, it's just under the breast, and you have a little plaster over that, and then you're wearing a sports bra for 6 weeks. We recommend taking a few days off work. If you're in a job, you know, a desk job, take 3 days off. If you're a little bit more active, I definitely would recommend 10 days to 2 weeks. How you'll feel is, it's like going to the gym and you work out your upper body and you haven't been to the gym for months, and you go home, you go to bed, and you get up the next morning, the next thing you move, and you kind of feel, oh, you're stiff and tender.
Yeah.
So you're not in a lot of pain, but you're stiff and tender. So you'll be aware of that, but you're given medication to make that comfortable for you. So it's not contrary to what you hear, you're not in agony.
Yeah.
The one thing that we pride ourselves on here in the clinic is our 7 days a week aftercare. If you have a problem, we're available no matter what time it is, you just pick up the phone. Again, anyone considering a breast augmentation, I would say to them to make sure that you have someone who's properly qualified, such as a consultant plastic surgeon who's registered on the Irish Medical Council. That's so important, okay. Because some, you know, people can call themselves cosmetic surgeons. That doesn't mean anything. It just means that they're a general surgeon.
So that's a way of you being able to tell that this person is fully qualified and that you're in safe hands.
Exactly. So, and that's really, really, really important. And again, we always recommend that patients stay overnight in hospital. In the unlikely event something would happen, it's safer to be in the hospital and for your surgeon to be there for 24 hours.
And is there anything you should know about afterwards? Like, let's say if I am looking into having implants, but mm-hmm. then I'm wondering about having kids, or like, can I breastfeed afterwards? Like, what should you know around those kind of areas?
It's a really good question. After breast augmentation, you can breastfeed. A lot of women ask me that question, should I have my breasts done before I have my children? That's a really personal question. It's very, very hard to answer it. However, the implant doesn't change even when you get pregnant, but your breast tissue can.
Okay.
So it depends how your breasts react through your pregnancy. So if you're someone who, you know, isn't planning to have children for another 10 years, I would say, well, personally, you know, that's up to you, but you've 10 years before you want to have children. So it's very, very personal. The implant, but mainly the main thing to know is the implant doesn't change, but your breast tissue may.
Okay. And what about in terms of, like, will they feel different? Like, is sensitivity reduced? Things like that?
No. That's a really, really interesting is, yes, straight away they'll feel different. You will feel, it's interesting, you will feel the weight of the implant for the first 2 days. And then the body's amazing, it tricks you, and you forget.
Probably feel like it's always been there.
It feels like it's always been there. But psychologically, if you're used to not having a breast, it takes a little bit of getting used to having, you know, looking in the mirror and going, wow, I have a boob. Also, the first 6 weeks, they're swollen, they're hard, they don't look that pretty, you know. So, you know, you're aware of that. But as, you know, in that, over the 6 week period post your surgery, swelling starts to settle down, the breasts move back into their natural fold, and usually at 6 weeks you're going, wow, I love them. At 12 weeks you think, well, they're beginning to feel really part of me, and a year in you don't feel you have an implant, but the first few weeks, yeah, you'd be aware you have an implant.
Yeah. And then if someone's getting breast implants, how long will they last? Like, are they going to get to need to have them done down the line again, or how will that?
They are. They're like a car. They need to be replaced. The recommendation by the company who makes the implants is 10 to 12 years that your implants are replaced.
The cost of a breast augmentation is €5,500. That includes everything from your overnight stay in hospital, your implants, and your unlimited aftercare, which extends, you know, there's no timeline on it. It could be 2 years, 5 years, 10 years. We're available to see you if you've any worries or complications. Obviously, price is a big consideration for people when they're going ahead with surgery, but I would tell them to be cautious. Sometimes people are looking to have surgeries overseas. I would advise patients not to go that route. If they've any problems or complications, then they're in trouble. They don't have their existing doctor or practice available to look after them. And there's the worry, who's going to take over the care? We hear from people on a weekly basis, and unfortunately, because they're not our patients, we can't see them here. And then a lot of them have to go back into the public system or go back to that country, and it gets very expensive and very distressing.